Then question number 59 is very simple. It is saying we have given these three processes and we are given arrival time and burst time. We have to find out the Gantt chart according to the primitive SJFS. Okay, remember this is primitive SJFS, which means a process can be preempted if new process comes with less burst time. So initially P only one process is available on the arrival time 0. So we will schedule P1 on 0. 0 to 1, P1 will run. Then on 1, we have a smaller process, that is P2. So P2 will run completely because this process will always be smaller. Okay, so 1 to 5, this will run. And now this becomes 6 because we have already run P1 for one time unit. Then P3 is 8. This means we have only two processes in the ready queue, that is P1 and P3, because P2 is already completed. So in P1 and P3, P1 is smallest process, okay, shortest process. So P1 will run from 5 to 11. Then we have only one process, that is P3, which will run from 11 to 19. So the Gantt chart will be like this, that is option 2.